Hey everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays. Enter the Gungeon. Sorry for the late Gungeons the last couple of days. They're still coming. It's just, if I do one Gungeon a day, I have to upload it overnight. Because I do not wake up at 8 in the morning. I know, what a lazy man. But how am I gonna shitpost on Twitter at 2 a.m. if I have to wake up at 8 every day? I can't set the thumbnail and the title, etc., etc., etc. So they've been coming out a little late. Lately, but I'm trying to get a little bit more of a backlog going here. And you know what? You might say the robot's not next in the rotation. The Marine is next in the rotation. And I say, you know what? Don't talk to me about the Marine unless you're going to talk to me about John Cena's 2009 film of the same name, The Marine. Not the Marina. That's not John Cena. That's probably like Beau Bridges or something like that. Not Bo Burnham. That's something completely different. I don't like being in the center of this. Why do I always stand in the center? But I figured let's go for the robot. I had a decent run last time. We lost on the Lich fight, as we have done with some regularity lately. I'm fairly happy about that, to be honest with you. Or at least, I shouldn't say happy, because you shouldn't be happy with a loss. You know, a loss by 2 points in a basketball game is still a loss. You don't go into the locker room and say... Look, you might go into the locker room and say this. I've never been a very good basketball player, but I imagine you don't go into the locker room and say, hey, we've lost our last 10 games in a row by 2 points. We're still doing pretty good, you guys. But that's kind of the attitude that I'm taking on here, but this is probably why I'd be a terrible, coach in the world of sports. I believe too much in math. I think that's, like, the way they talk about it in, like, stuff like Moneyball is that math is, like, immutable in sports. Like, look at Moneyball, man. All you gotta do is be a math genius. Well, yeah, I mean, true. But also, the Oakland A's, like, under the ownership or the management of Billy Beane, have never won the World Series. In fact, they've never, made the World Series, to the best of my memory. Under Billy Beane's, management. That's not to say he hasn't made the team successful and made him an awful lot of money. I'm just saying. I believe too much in variance. That's why I don't like the playoffs that much. It's exciting, don't get me wrong. In terms of excitement, it's good. But whenever, especially like, you know, game sevens or like elimination games. But then when people are like, the playoffs prove like who really wants it, I'm like, yo, everybody wants it, man. They're all professional athletes here. You discount an entire like 80 game season based on, you know, 4 bad games in the playoffs or something like that. It doesn't make any mathematical sense to me. Corpses explode. This is not very good in my opinion. I'd much rather have the coolant, and especially, like, corpses explode makes no sense for me to take right now, when I'm the robot and armor is so valuable to me. So, I figured we're gonna play as the robot this time. Played fairly well on the last run, kind of threw it a little bit on, floor 4 and I guess bullet hell to some extent as well, but, I'm hopeful that I'm in a good place in my Gungeon life, and maybe we can get the robot, something accomplished at least. I was talking to Austin about it. I was like, man, I really wish the robot could have, like, a little buff. He's very strong, but some kind of defensive buff would change everything. Potion of Gun Friendship is pretty good, but... and he was like, I don't know if I necessarily agree, because I'm, like, the Enter the Gungeon Ubermensch, you know? I'm the world's greatest Enter the Gungeon player, and every character's easy for me. I won 130 runs in a row. Honestly, the game needs a hard mode. You're a piece of shit, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, whoa, dude, you're coming a little bit over the top there. He didn't actually say all of that stuff. I inferred some of it from his manner of speech. He let me in on a little bit of his personal experience, and he said, you know what, don't sweat it. The robot's tough. Well, I guess we're just gonna let that go. He's not an easy character to win with, and he was actually one of the ones that gave Austin some trouble as well. Oh, insane in the brain! Insane in the membrane. Dude, this is huge. I am gonna go... Well, I mean, I guess if that's Map Man, we're just gonna get the map, right? But, or not get the map, but you know what I mean. The membrane should give us a great chance to flawless this boss. Especially because it has range. But we can use the robot's right hand if we want to stay even further away. I'm just looking for secret rooms right now. Okay, that's obviously it's not going to be there. Let's see if we have blanks left over after the boss fight, and then we'll maybe just use them on the shop or something. It is Trigger Twins, which I think is fine. Oh my god, I almost got hit right off the bat. Like, maybe a good idea is to not just stand right freaking in there. Actually, I had a terrible moment there for a second. I was like, did I get hit? But I didn't get hit. Dude, we are able to recharge the coolant so quickly as a result of the extra damage we're doing with the membrane here. The ammo's probably already gone. We probably cannot go pick it up. But at least we got, well, the mutation's okay. And then we get the extra armor, and then we get another piece of armor here. And the mutation does give us range at the very least. Yeah, the ammo's gone. That's fine. Alright, we're gonna head down to the next floor. 8 armor, that's pretty good. Where we would like to be for the first floor. We might want to use the mutation for the next boss, we'll see. Not only because it gives us extra range, but because it allows us to preserve membrane ammo a little bit longer. And I do think the membrane is a better weapon than the mutation long term, but this is actually a pretty good start considering that I really did not enjoy... Ooh, that was close. Considering that I really did not enjoy our first active slash passive item. In fact, when I get active items, most of the time I'm unhappy. I want those, you know, damn dirty passive synergies. So rarely does the game find it in its heart to give me more than one, you know, solid passive item on a run. Bums me out, man. But so far, you know, we haven't been hit. That'll change. There's no way you go through a whole Gungeon run without taking... There's no way I go through a whole Gungeon run without taking damage. Maybe, you know, I'm sure... If you challenge the internet to accomplish a gaming-related feat, they're always going to rise to the occasion. The dude who beat Dark Souls without getting hit, people have beaten Dark Souls on the fucking Donkey Kong bongos, like... Never underestimate the spirit of mankind, because you'll lose every time. And I know people are always, oh, I'm disappointed in humanity. I think there's reasons to be disappointed in humanity, sometimes. I try to maintain optimism, but you know, there are some times when it's, mankind is not a nice and generous species. Might be worth getting the backpack here, but let's explore a little bit. The backpack gives us all... No, it just gives us a second active item. Unfortunately, this would have been amazing on the last floor, but we're not on the last floor. But, the indomitable spirit of man is an incredible thing. Oh, I did get hit there. I really thought a well-timed roll could have saved me. And maybe it could have, and my roll was just not well-timed. You know, we're the same species that, you know, landed a dude on the moon. We are also the same species that gave you the television program Here Comes Honey Boo Boo. But you gotta take the good with the dubious. Not bad. Just a child. I'm not gonna insult the child. Especially Honey Boo Boo child. But, she's still around. I'm not asking if she's dead. But when was Honey Boo Boo big? That was back in, like, 2010, right? So that kid is, like, 13 now? Is that show still on? I have to imagine I would be seeing it all the time if it were actually still on. Because, you know, I am the dude who, when he's folding his laundry at, like, 1 a.m., turns on A&E, and I go, oh, what horrible drug is this person addicted to? Wow, what a cautionary tale, but mostly I'm just watching it going, thank God I'm not that person, right? What a troubling portrayal of addiction that makes me feel good about my own life. Clearly my problems are not that big. At least I'm not huffing, you know, Elmer's glue out of a dirty gym sock. But I think that I would be seeing a Honey Boo Boo on the screen, were that the case. I'd be seeing Honey Boo Boo marathons. Instead, it's all... A&E, at least up here in Canada, is all escaping polygamy right now. A show that I'm about 99,000% sure is just completely fake. We have no keys. Just wanted to make sure I'm not shooting at the, the ricochets are not going to hit the chest. Alright, let's move along here. That and Storage Wars. Look, for a long time, or at least a couple of years, I was pretty, like, okay with Storage Wars. I was like, this is some relatively harmless reality TV. You learn a little bit about these items. Of course it's all fucking fake. Like, that's fairly obvious, especially in hindsight. But I just can't handle the wave, like, living in a post-Storage Wars universe. Where you turn on the TV and it's American Restorators! Or Restorators. American Pickers! American Junkyard Scrapmen! And I'm like, first off, where's our Canadian representation? I guess we have, like, Highway to Hell or whatever it's called, where people are like, you know, highways in Canada?
get real ice, you people die in car accidents.
It's true, man. That's like nothing to joke about. Because it's the holster, I feel content to just go with the membrane here, especially considering we just had full ammo. Or just ammo show up for it. Might need to use a blank here. You know what? Better safe than sorry, right? Or as we say in Canada, better safe and sorry. That, there's a little bit of an elegance to that joke that I'm actually fond of. Oh yeah, just jump in the pit, smart idea. What's the secret to fighting the easiest second floor boss? Jump in the fucking pit, great start. We've lost 3 HP on this floor, which is very embarrassing. And we got a -2 net change here. Hopefully we get armor back. We did not get armor back for this, and we got Alien Engine. Yo, that sucks. Ah, that feels bad. Alright, it's not the end of the world. We're still going here, but 5 HP is not... Excuse me. Where you want to be at this point on your run. And it's really like a textbook example of how one poor decision, or, well... It was a split-second decision, but a decision nonetheless can really fuck you up here. If we just blanked or rolled in the other direction, we would have been fine, probably. I don't know if you buy the backpack. I'm really struggling here, man. Come on, come on. One of these days, we're going to get this, like, ideal robot win. But if not now, when? If not now, when? No matter what this is, we're probably gonna wanna just destroy it. Like, if we buy a key, we're not gonna use it on the brown chest. And to be honest with you, I can have a gun, I can have a passive or an active, and either one of those is fine by me. Armor's 30, which means we won't be able to buy the backpack, but I think we've gotta make a more sensible decision and go with this right now. And we're going to open the green chest. I hope it's a dope passive, because we're actually okay on guns right now. But we'll see. Yeah, that's fireproof, right? Fire and poison proof? That's actually really good. Fire, poison, and electricity. And the world is made of energy. And the whole world is electricity. Yeah, apples in stereo? Anyone? You know. Elephant Six movement in Athens, Georgia. I was there. I wasn't there. I was like 9. But you know, everyone knows Neutral Milk Hotel. I love you, Mathens Games. That's the overlap between, you know, people who love In the Aeroplane Over the Sea and people who know who Mathens Games is. Probably Neutral Milk Hotel is the limiting reagent there. I'm joking. Obviously, everybody. Everybody knows Neutral Milk Hotel at this point. When I was in high school, before, you know, the Pitchfork medias and all that, if you knew Neutral Milk Hotel, you were like a real, you know, OG status, A-Town's very own. Now if you know Neutral Milk Hotel, people were like, oh, I'm listening to Glitch Trap now. Don't even start with me. Neutral Milk Hotel? Yeah, it was my favorite album when I was 9. Things change, man. Culture evolves. For better and for worse and for lateral moves. Please. There's a joke in my head, but it gets a little too, like, circle jerky. Or I'm like, you know, the lead singer of Neutral Milk Hotel. If you're not familiar with Neutral Milk Hotel is, this discussion's gonna be over in like 10 seconds anyway. His name's Jeff Mangum. And then I'm thinking of like, you know, there should be like a sketch. It would have to be on Portlandia or something like that. But instead of like Trojan Magnums, it would be Trojan Mangums for the sensitive man in your life who's also about to have sexual intercourse. And has a huge dick. Okay, well, I mean, see, there's a punchline in there. We kind of ironically Trojan horse the punchline in. I'm just going to pick up a key because I want to buy armor, actually. I know this thing's right over here. If we can't buy a key, we can't buy a key. We can still buy a key. The med kit is meaningless for us. We buy armor. We should be able to afford a key later. We got to rebuild our armor stock, basically. We can actually, like, come out of this just fine. I'd really like to flawless this boss, though. Like, if we don't flawless this boss, and we don't get armor from the boss drop, it's gonna be a hard time for us, I think. I like how it says, you know, you're immune to electricity with this suit, but we already have immunity to electricity, do we not? Like, as the robot, I don't think I've ever hit myself with my own electricity. Let me try the mutation out, see if maybe this is what we need here. The only problem... Oh my fucking god. The only problem that I see with the mutation right now is that, it does kind of knock us back. Excuse me? Hold up. Somebody, John Madden, Al Michaels, give me the footage of that, okay? My brain took a snapshot. It may be a biased snapshot, that's why I need an impartial observer out here, like Al Michaels of Monday Night Football fame. I looked as I got hit, and my brain said, what the fuck's going on? You're in your dodge roll. I feel, this is the first time I've felt betrayed in my entire life. Mostly I've had a pretty privileged existence, to be honest with you. But at the same time, where, oh Jesus Christ. Oh God, nice, good, smart move. Where the heck was my iframes there? I must be mistaken. I know that there was a problem with the iframes on robot and bullet, but I thought that those had been taken care of. At least we got armor back. But still, I mean, I'm not done with this run. Like, I'm not thinking we're fucked or anything like that, but we may be fucked. We have 6 armor, and we're not even done the third floor yet. This could be a pretty poor robot run, but it's, you know, that's life. Instead of using the robot's right hand, I think we're going to go with the Colt 45 for now. You know what? Figured we might as well give this a shot. We're going to go with the Colt 45 because of the fact that freezing enemies might be good for us defensively speaking. Oh, Jesus. And it still gets the shock bullets. It still seems to do, the, you know, decent damage. That was a nice explosion there. Lucky me. And membrane is definitely going to be the first to take ammo, the first to get ammo for us if we find ammo drops. But this is at least a source to deposit ammo if we want. Oh, cool! This is interesting. So the Colt 45 actually freezes the coolant, which is bad because it makes us slide around, and also apparently ice is non-conductive. So Ring of Miserly Protection actually does nothing for us. This is a... I was talking to Austin about this, that, there's no way I'm going to say this that it doesn't come across as being salty. I hope that, you know, those of you who have been watching this series for a long time recognize that I like Gungeon a lot. Things that I bring up as criticisms, you can criticize something without it being, like, a knock on the game. It's not like this takes it from being, you know, a 9 out of 10 to a 4 or something like that. I was talking to Austin, I was like, you know what one awesome step for the robot would be? HP upgrades actually give you HP up. Why does the orange, like, not even HP up, just armor up. Okay, don't dodge roll in this room. I accept. Why do the flawlesses give you HP up, or armor up as the robot, when you get the orange, or you get heart lunchbox, or you get, you know, heart locket, stuff like that? Those don't provide you with extra armor, and we saw the same situation here with the Ring of Miserly Protection. I would feel a little bit safer as the... It probably wouldn't make enough of a difference to give me the win, if I'm being honest. But it's a start. Like, why don't all HP upgrades give you armor? Why do only some HP upgrades give you armor? It just strikes me as strange. We got the utility belt, all capacity up. This is nice. I'm really glad that we did not purchase the backpack as a result. Now we can hold a second item either way. We don't really care about getting a brown chest. That's one key for a brown chest, because the red hearts do nothing for us. Me personally, yeah, the judge is great. I'm not a game designer. So the stuff that I say is spitballing. And I really do, I get annoyed sometimes when people, you know, they make a review. This is not to say, like... Another criticism that I get really annoyed with is when people go, oh, you don't like this game? Why don't you make something better? Like, that's not how this works. You know, the best critics are not going to be the people who are, like, making the best games in the world. Because if they could make the best games in the world, why are they being critics? They could be out there making, you know, FIFA 2018. That comment's going to go over well. Wait, where was I going with this? Oh, I do, sometimes when I read reviews of stuff, I cringe a little bit, and they're like, why didn't they go in this direction? And I'm like, well, maybe it's not that easy. Like, maybe they tried it, maybe they tested it, maybe the game actually looked like that for, like, 6 weeks, and then they decided that, you know, it sounded great in theory, but it actually sucked. Like, these people live the game as they're building, and they build it for, like, 2 years. Why didn't we try that? Well, the answer is we freaking did, obviously. Not really that into that. I guess we'll go to our... You know what? Let's try down in this special room down here. But for me personally, my gut, and this could be completely wrong, my gut says, why not just do it so the robot starts with, like, 3 armor instead of 6, but if you flawless the boss, you get a red heart. The maximum amount of red hearts you could have by flawlessing all 5 bosses every single time is 5. And 3 armor means that, you know, unlike 6 armor, you have no guarantee of survival on the first floor. You can fairly easily get hit 3 times on the first floor. I think, at least. Most of the time, even a player as bad as myself doesn't get hit 3 times on the first floor. But it definitely, like, if you got hit twice and then went into the boss fight, you'd be shitting your pants, right? So the Colt 45 is out of ammo. I think we can afford to go with the Judge. Let's give it a shot. I mean, we're not high on HP, so we should take risks, I think, to make our life easier on this floor, hopefully. Might it make the game too easy? It might, honestly. And by making the game more difficult, it takes me out of my comfort zone, which is a good thing. You know, eventually, I think I've gotten better at Gungeon because Gungeon is hard. You know, but it's hard to say, like, you gotta strike a good balance between challenge and frustration. And I do think that a lot of my colleagues stopped playing Gungeon because the level of frustration, especially with the length of the runs, has surmounted the level of satisfaction, or, you know, the level of difficulty has precluded them from, like, super enjoying it. And I'll admit, I might have been there for a little while, you know, losing, like, 8 runs in a row. Getting my ass kicked, dying on, like, the 4th floor, it's a drag, man. But once you get past it, there's a lot of beauty to love here. And especially, like, when we were on that 3 win streak, I was like, I actually get Gungeon now. I'm not the best Gungeon player in the world, I'm not perfect, but I get it right now. Like, I understand the language this game is speaking, and I'm working through it, and I'm trying to get better, and I'm dedicated to doing that right now. Oh, dude, Pax Cannon, a.k.a. the Pox Cannon, because it's its actual name. I think we can actually roll with this and save the Judge for the next floor. This is actually quite good. And we're immune to poison, which is amazing. But yeah, I sort of feel like, you know, start the robot off with less armor, but give him the ability to actually take HP. That's my hunch. And again, you know, this is just spitballing. This is just I'm just prototyping it. In my head, just in concept, you know, I haven't actually tried it in reality. But oftentimes, when you say, like, why didn't they do this? Sometimes there's a good reason. Sometimes there's not a good reason. But oftentimes there's an actual reason. Anyway. Let's so be careful here. These guys are not dying. Had to, unfortunately. Oh, you know, they will die. Okay, I know that, like, I need to get up there and kill the dude who is protecting them. I don't want to talk about that situation right there. I thought I landed that dodge, but clearly I overshot it a little bit. Haven't been super thrilled with the robot's dodge in this episode. I gotta be real with you. Like, one way or the other, we're on 4th floor. We're on floor 4. This one's making it to YouTube. But if we die on the 4th floor, I'm gonna be pissed. And it's largely my own fault. I fucked up 2 flawlesses, and honestly, fucking up 2 flawlesses is not something I can blame on the game. Even if a couple of those dodges, I was like, I hit it. Still can't really rely on that. Rat's not taking the chest, so we don't have to sweat that. And in terms of, like, actives, or guns at least, we've done fairly well. We have no passives except for immunity to poison, which is actually pretty good, but immunity to poison and fire. And electricity, but I don't want to give the game credit for giving me immunity to electricity, because it doesn't seem like that makes any dang difference. Alright, easy enough. That's a tricky roll. And we got our boss fight. Honestly, I feel like we might as well do it right now. Let's go for it. And it is going to be the Kill Pillars. With, like, piercing shots from the membrane, I feel like Kill Pillars should not be insurmountable. Are we going to get the Flawless? I rarely have the balls to call a Flawless on a fourth floor boss. It's just, like, there's too many variables. But we have a really, really nice array of weapons to Flawless this boss, potentially. I would love to have, like, one more blank would make me feel a lot better. But we still have one blank. There we go. You know what? Now no matter what happens, I can at least be proud of that. And that didn't take very much ammo at all, but we will refill our membrane. You know, we got the dragon fire, which is an amazing weapon. I'm gonna use the Pax Cannon for now, aka the Pox Cannon, because that's its actual name. We might as well just do this. Oh, that was actually closer than I'd like to admit. Yeah, the Dragonfire is amazing. We're definitely gonna use that for boss killing, even more so than the membrane, I think. I'm not sure, is the dragon immune to fire? I was gonna say, he's gotta be done. Well, this gives me, like, a new lease on life, but at the same time, like, I'm just looking at the math of the situation right now, and I'm like, it's hard to imagine us getting the win here just because of the fact that we're on 5 armor going down to floor 5, and sure, we just flawless the boss, but really all that did was kind of keep me in a holding pattern. We needed more than the boss flawless. We need to buy armor from the shop. You know, I was hoping that we'd get armor as just a drop from the boss, and that didn't really work out. Again, it's my own fault for putting us in this situation to begin with, and you know, I think I would have much more of a case for being like, Gungeon is unfair sometimes, if I didn't have a friend who beat the game 130 times in a row. And this sounds, again, like, I hope this doesn't sound like salt. I'm very appreciative of it. I've gotten a 100 plus win streak in Isaac, and I know what it takes. You know, sometimes you've got to win runs that are a little tougher than other ones, but no run is effectively unwinnable. Some are just harder, so I would never call Isaac unfair. Sometimes it's quite rude, but unfair, I wouldn't say so. So I'm empowered to know that, to know that Gungeon is beatable on basically every single run. At least 99%. You know, splitting hairs here. I guess if you win 130 runs in a row and you extrapolated that as the one truth, it would be like, you know, 99.4% in a row or something. But anyway, it's empowering. It's empowering to know that, you know, even in this situation, there's got to be a way out. Some kind of shrine in here. I guess YV would be nice. It's not YV, it's Blank Man. And he also found us the secret room, which is lovely. We're going to take another blank, and we're just going to use the blank. First, we're going to open this chest. Cigarettes. We can hold a second item, but we definitely don't want to use it here. And we did get another chest. We just want to go check the shop first, just to see if there's keys for sale. Because there are two keys on the ground. We probably want to start with, the green chest, and then go to the blue chest. Oh, dude, you need a key to get into the shop? That's rude. That is rude. There's another shop down here. It's actually a gun muncher. I you know what? Okay, I'm gonna gun munch the Colt 45. And I'm gonna gun munch the alien engine. The only way I'll use the alien engine, and it would be amazing if we could get this, but the only way I'd use it is if we could get Potion of Lead Skin, Ethereal Form, something like that. Frost Giant is A-okay. Not great, but totally fine. A gun we'll actually possibly use. Alright, so we're not gonna go to our shop. Let's grab our keys. And we have a green chest and a blue chest in a room. And, well, if you have a blue chest in a room, why not just open this blue chest? Please don't be a mimic. It is exploding stump, which I actually think is okay. Largely as a result of the fact that our other active item was the cigarettes. So at least we can have, like, a decoy here? I think that's okay. Obviously, like, the blank would be better or something like that. But let's see what we've got in our green chest in here. Hegemony rifle. So precise, they say. So precise. So seductive. I'll give you the hegemony gun. It isn't really that much fun, but it's a reliable one. Eat your broccoli, hun. Whoa! And yeah, at the end of the song, it became like your mom singing to you. Alright, well, we got 5 HP. Like, that's bad. It's not 5 HP. It's really 2.5 HP. 5 armor. But, we played really well on that floor. At least we didn't die on the fourth floor. I won't be content with the run unless we beat the dragon. Not beating the dragon is like, it's a failure. But at least on the fourth floor, we did really well. I think we did really well. I'm not gonna pat myself on the back so hard that I, you know, break my spine. Billy Joel Osment from Green Day. His name is not Billy Joel Armstrong, that's it. It's Billy Joel Osment. There's a Photoshop challenge for you. Former child actor, now adult actor, Haley Joel Osment with Green Day. Oh, okay, that was close. Green Day lead singer Billy Joe Armstrong's hair, but it's gotta be his hair from 2005 American Idiot era Green Day. It can't just be him from, like, you know, 1997. Lucky number 1997. But, it can't be Nimrod era. It's gotta be American Idiot era. Otherwise, it's just not gonna fit. 4 HP. I hate moving the goalposts like this, but I do feel like, you know, my proximate, not approximate, just, you know, my short-term goal should be, beating the dragon. And if we beat the dragon, we die on bullet hell. I'll at least, you know, I'll leave this run being like, we didn't totally fuck it up as the robot. The second and third floor boss fights ruined me. If you want to know, like, where this run became very tough to imagine a win, as much as I hate to admit it, it happened really early. It was that Beholster fight. We did really well on the Trigger Twins, and then I fucked it on the Beholster fight by trying to dodge into the abyss for reasons unbeknownst. So, I think now we're going to go Hegemony Rifle. And, like, I'm not in love with this setup we've got going on right here. Figure, let the explosive stump take out as much of the riffraff as possible. And the hegemony rifle, you know what? It might be awesome if we could get, like, scope or something like that. And I'm not talking about a mouthwash. We have 87 credits. In all likelihood, that means we buy armor and maybe ammo from, and maybe a key, I guess, from our forge or our blacksmith. But it depends what's on sale. If we really stretch, we might be able to buy a passive. But passives can be as much as like a... Okay, that one came in hot. Passives can be as much as 180 credits down here, so... That ain't no joke, man. Come on. Come on. We should not just be using the stump. We do still have coolant. Oh, scary times. Scary times. Oh, we have the heroin for 104. And no armor. So I think that, yeah, I mean, a key would be nice. But it's probably more important to buy an item like the heroin, which is great for room clearing and boss killing, than it is to buy, you know, a key in the hopes of winning the lottery. And what lottery would we hope we'd be hoping to win? Like, what's the grand prize of the chest lottery? Honestly, if I got the heroin for a key, I'd be like, we did it. So we might as well just cut the middleman out here. And there's the boss fight. I actually feel like our chances of winning are probably improved by going to the boss fight as soon as possible. All I want to do is use the heroine as... Wow, that was close. As much as we need to... use the hegemony rifle as much as we need to get the heroine, then go into this boss fight. And what I meant to say, of course, was, all I want to do is bang, 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 and a ch-ch-choo, and take your money. I grew up in... My formative years were in 2007 when this song was really popular. Oh, what the? It appeared out of the wall. Okay? There are some as much as I've defended, you know, game developers and designers. Fuck them. They screwed me on this run as much as I screwed myself. We got 99, we got 101 Dalmatians. Well, you know what? There is a there's a chest just over here, presumably. Might as well shoot the last two bullets out of this thing. All right, what comes next? I guess we go back to the judge temporarily. I really want 2 HP to kill the dragon. I mean, I'd really rather have like 8, but 2 is like the bare minimum. We will have a key to open this. If this is a mimic, you know, cancel Christmas. Oh, it's a good chest. Really? The serious cannon? Kind of, you know, I don't mean to be rude, but it took me by surprise to get... I didn't realize this gun was considered that good. Alright, just take these guys out ASAP. I did not even see you. Oh god, I can't stop firing. Oh, they're frozen. It's perfect. We got 103 credits. Oh, 104. Okay, that's it. Especially considering we don't have another key and we're very unlikely to afford another one. This is it. What? Puccini pouring from the sky. Let's get rich. What? But actually, like, this is incredibly dangerous. I mean, we might be able to muster a chance at bullet hell, but what it's gonna take is a flawless here. There's like no doubt in my mind. Might as well. I hate to use it in that situation. I think we might have been able to get our way out of there. Dragonfire is doing just fine though. A little bit slow on the reload time, but as you can see, like it's potent. So I'm saving the stump for when the SMGs get created. That was a little dicey. Nice. We want to save the blanks as long as possible. I'm actually thinking maybe we go membrane, honestly. Because the dragon fire might be better on a boss that has a little bit less tankiness. And honestly, like, the membrane has been quite spectacular for us. And I think it actually is doing better than the dragon fire. The Dragonfire will save for the Lich. I know that's pretty unlikely that we ever come to that situation to begin with. But this just goes to show you, like, I'm not tapping out of this run, right? Like, I'm in for the chance of victory. I'm operating under the principle that we may indeed make it to the Lich fight. The odds of this, I'd say, are fairly unfavorable, but I'm not bowing out yet. And then what do you use on the next phase? I mean, I don't think the serious cannon is the right thing. We'll try the serious cannon on bullet hell. I mean, like, if it's in a red chest, we might as well give it a shot. I don't think a red chest is a guarantee that it's gonna be good. But someone thought it was good, at least, to put it in there. Is this gonna get it done during the second phase here? I don't know. But honestly, it seems okay for now. Trying not to talk, because, you know, just lowers my chances of success here. I think we're probably gonna have to do one more phase of dodging. That's fine. Deep breath. 0 credits, 0 keys. Combi and... Oh! Reaction. Okay, this is the... The principle still holds. Beat the dragon. There's no way we live on bullet hell. But to at least beat the dragon is something here. I feel like a 5 out of 10 baseline level of pride. We were pretty close to getting the flawless, and it makes a huge difference, man. We would have been at 3 armor instead of 1. Are we likely to win in that situation? No. You know what? I've decided, let's try to use the dragon fire to clear rooms. Like, we might as well go for broke, right? Like, we stand to lose nothing by using the most powerful weapon. And it didn't seem that good against the dragon, but it could just be that the dragon's tanky and all that. But for now, I think this is a good idea. And anytime we live on bullet hell is gravy at this point. There's a 5% chance we win this run at this point. I would say maybe even a little less. As long as I didn't get killed by my own explosion in there, there's, you know, something to be semi-proud of, I guess. Oh, I hate these guys. And anybody who thinks that I'm gonna throw it down here on bullet hell to finish the run faster doesn't know enough about old Northern Lion. You don't need to throw on bullet hell. Bullet hell will instigate the throw for you. At the very least, my incredibly bullshit streak of beating the dragon but not the actual boss of the game continues. So, kudos to me, I guess, for beating easy mode. There was a time when it looked like the fourth floor was going to be not possible for us on this run, so to die on the fifth floor, although we're not dead yet, to probably die on the fifth floor doesn't make me feel too bad. Dude, Dragonfire has been actually sweet for us so far. That's gonna be a heck of a dodge. Curving shots are just so difficult to track on the way in, man. They're just so differential equations to track on the way in. Where'd you think I was going with that sentence? Obviously, I was gonna talk about the diffy cues. Figure throw down the decoy. The decoy doesn't really benefit us here because these enemies aren't really shooting at us. They're just shooting, you know, from a radius around them, or in a circumference around them. No, in a radius. It doesn't matter. Dragonfire is almost out of ammo. You know what? 36 shots on the Sirius cannon. Oh, Jesus Christ. It's weird because you're like, this is pretty good. Do I want to save it for bullet hell? Well, we're already on bullet hell. Do I want to save it for the Lich? Well, we're probably not going to make it to the Lich, but we got a better chance of making it to the Lich if we use our best weapon as a room clearer, I guess, in the meantime. But the heroine's fine. We know the heroine's a good weapon. This room sucks. What's the big thing? I was going to say, if you can get to the place where they don't aggro you, that's a good thing. I hate that I did it, but I feel like that was a very sensible decision. In all honesty, you know, the blanks are of critical importance, and I want to put up a fight down here, and so far I'd say we've basically achieved that, and we got a blank back, so no problems. How crazy would it be if we did actually win this run? The answer is very crazy. Shouldn't do this. Okay, we made it. Enemies have got to go. Enemies that create skellies have really got to go. There's no skellies, right? We killed both of the skelly generators.
We've got to kill the skelly generators. Hey!
This is... Ah! Oh, okay. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the run as much as I did. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.